Today at D23, we got our first look at Emma Stone in the Cruella prequel. And the internet fell in love. I tweeted just one word, perfect. And I dare anyone to disagree with me. I don't think anyone will. It is perfect. Seriously, of all the movies that were covered during the panel that had no end, it went on forever. And it felt particularly long because there weren't a lot of major announcements, which tend to make the time go by quicker. And this, which was one of the few genuine reveals at the panel, well, this trended the highest and the longest. Because Stone not only looks fabulous here, but it's a very different take on the character. Yes, it was revealed that the movie takes place in 1970s London. I got a lot to say about that. We'll get to that in a moment. And as you can see, it features a punk rock Cruella. An interesting time period to choose because the original novel came out in 1956 and the Disney animated classic in 1961. But the animated classic, by the way, rare for Disney, but that felt particularly of the time of the era it was released. Disney animation tends to be timeless, but 101 Dalmatians was highly stylized. So in that regard, this does make sense to have a highly stylized representation of an era. But why the 70s? So I think stylistically, there are some great choices. There are some great aspects to this choice. But from a business perspective, if this movie is a hit, and so far so good out of the gate, it could backdoor a new 101 Dalmatians movie with an older actress taking the role of Cruella today, right? In modern times, because again, this is a prequel. Or if you wanted to keep Emma Stone in the role, you could spotlight Cruella during different decades. Wonder Woman style. Everyone's copying everyone these days. And this is actually not the only DC reference in this video. Now, in terms of announcements, they also clarified that the movie has been pushed back, although it looks so good, we'll wait. It's been pushed back another year to 2021 for Memorial Day weekend, which is now Disney's friend again after Aladdin was such a huge hit. Billion Dollar Club, baby! Could a movie like this make $1 billion? I think if they really play into some of the things that I'm going to bring up, maybe it could. So let's break down this fabulous photo. So the 1970s were an iconic time, particularly in the UK, pop culture-wise. On the music scene, you had Freddie Mercury, Elton John, and David Bowie. Odds are this movie will have a killer soundtrack. I wonder who Cruella's contemporaries are. She certainly looks like she knows the creme de la creme of what's going on in, on the London scene, right? But to me, this Cruella also is a reference to another pop culture 70s icon, and that's Tim Curry in the Rocky Horror Picture Show. She not only looks like Curry in that film, and he's a UK talent, by the way, but she even seems to be, I think, in many ways, copying his body language. And Rocky Horror Picture Show, by the way, was shot and produced in the UK, interestingly enough. But another thing I like about this photo that one of you pointed out to me on Twitter when I tweeted about it is that this younger Cruella is also looking very Harley Quinn. Oh my gosh. Could Disney be trying to create a family-friendly version of that character for themselves? That would be a great idea for Disney. Not so great for Warner Brothers and DC. And that's interesting. You know, everybody was really applauding Warner Brothers' choice to make Birds of Prey an R-rated movie, but that really makes it so that a number of people, people went to Deadpool, but I guess it depends on how it's R-rated. Deadpool was R-rated, but still had a very light tone. And also, there's no alternative, right? If Disney can give you a PG-13 alternative to Harley Quinn, what will happen? I think that's very, very interesting. I'm also impressed with Emma Stone's continued range and that she hasn't abandoned the zany roles that made her famous as her star has risen. Speaking of Rocky Horror Picture Show, I think Susan Sarandon, career-wise, might be a good comparison. And apparently, Cruella and her henchmen go all the way back because that's Horace and Jasper behind her, looking just as perfect for the time period, and it's fabulous as Cruella. That's the UK's Joel Fry as Jasper, bringing some diversity to the film, but organically. I mean, his look just is perfect for what they're doing here. He looks so cool. Usually the henchmen are, bumbling idiots, right? And I'm sure Horace will help us out there. With all due respect, we'll talk about him in a moment. But, I wouldn't mind a super cool Jasper, and that's what it looks like we're getting there. Now, as for Horace, that's Paul Walter Hauser, who just finished filming the biggest role of his career to date, although maybe it'll end up being this one. But he's actually the lead in Richard Jewell in Clint Eastwood's Atlanta Olympics bombing movie. I'm not sure if Jewell is the actual lead, but it's the title character, and I'm sure it's a large role. He's also made a strong impression, at least in my opinion, in I, Tonya and Black Klansman. If you've seen either of those movies, you definitely know who Paul Walter Hauser is. Now, speaking of I, Tonya, Cruella has the same director, Craig Gillespie. He also did Lars and the Real Girl, United States of Tara, and what I felt was a pretty good remake, Fright Night. So that gives me also a good feeling about this movie. I like also the location of where they shot this, like on an abandoned lot. It looks like a music video in many ways, and some people also felt this was a little Gaga-esque. It seems more pointed. Lady Gaga, I think brilliantly so, is in broader strokes. This to me is very specific. And so I think it seems just a little more pinpointed, I guess you could say. Now, as for the people making, back to the people making this movie, the screenplay has unfortunately an alarming number of cooks in the kitchen. But most promising are Aline Brosh McKenna, the Crazy Ex-Girlfriend creator and Devil Wears Prada screenwriter. And then also recently added was Tony McNamara, who was the writer on Stone's recent The Favorite. Maybe she asked him to come in and do some last minute rewrites. Emma Thompson could also maybe contribute, even if uncredited, as she's also in the movie, but her role is still under wraps. Many fans noticed that Cruella's fur coat, her trademark fur coat, is nowhere to be seen. But if Cruella is going to be an anti-hero like Harley Quinn, she can't be wearing fur with today's audiences. Maybe she can go with animal prints, right? Not quite yet, but I could certainly see her going with faux animal prints. And, you know, that's, of course, very much in style today. We'll see what's in style in 2021. But when you go with black and white in a time period, I think that's a good way to play it safe. So what do you think of this new take on Cruella de Vil? Share your thoughts down below. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.